Hello everyone. In today's tutorial, I'll demonstrate how to install macOS Sequoia 15 Beta 5 on your internal or external SSD so that you can explore and test the new features of macOS Sequoia before the final version is released. I will install macOS Sequoia Beta 5 on a Samsung external SSD T7. However, if you have enough space on your internal SSD, I'll show you how to create a separate volume and install it on your internal drive. In any case, make sure you have backed up all your important files in case something goes wrong. As you know, this is a beta version and it's not yet time to replace your current macOS with a Sequoia beta version. If you have an external SSD, connect it to your Mac using the provided cable. Next, click the Spotlight search icon in the menu bar and type Disk Utility in the search box. Then click its icon or press Enter on your keyboard to launch it. If you haven't formatted your external drive, click the View menu and select Show All Devices. Next, locate your SSD in the left sidebar under External section. Before clicking the Erase button, ensure you have backed up all your important files. Erasing will completely wipe your drive. Enter a name for your drive, such as External SSD or macOS Sequoia Beta. For the format, select APFS and GUID partition map for the scheme and click Erase. I have already formatted this drive and don't want to erase it again. However, when you click the Erase button, you have to wait for a short time until Disk Utility finishes the erasing process, then click Done. This is my internal SSD and this is the external one. However, I don't want to use the whole capacity of my external SSD to install macOS 15 Sequoia Beta 5. I just want to use part of it. Therefore, I will create a separate APFS volume dedicated to macOS 15 Sequoia Beta. Let's start with the internal drive first. To create a volume on your internal SSD, select the container disk under the internal section. Click the plus button to add a volume. Enter a name for the volume, such as macOS Sequoia Beta. For the format, select APFS. Next, click the Size Options button and enter a size. For smooth performance, allow 30 GB or higher. If you have enough space, click OK, then click Add. Since I don't want to install macOS Sequoia Beta on my internal drive, I click the container disk under the external section. Next, I click the plus button in the toolbar to add a volume. In the name field, I enter macOS Sequoia Beta. Since I have a lot of free space on my external SSD, I enter 60 GB. Click OK and then click Add. To better understand the difference between the reserve size and quota size, watch this tutorial. Click More below the video to expand the description box on the YouTube website and access the link, or watch it at the end of this video. I now have two volumes, one for my backup and the other for installing macOS 15 Sequoia beta version. It is now time to download the macOS Sequoia installer. The easiest way to do it is to visit MrMacintosh.com, click the Sequoia installers, scroll down, and download the installer.
If you like this video, make sure to subscribe and ring the bell for more. Thank you.
Once the download is complete, double-click the package and click Continue. To ensure you will install it on the right volume, click Change Install Location. In my case, it is an external volume. Yours could be an internal volume. I'll select the volume on the external SSD and click Continue. Then click Install, enter my admin password and click Install Software. Next, you need to allow the installer to access files on a removable volume. Click Allow. In the following step, I open the volume, the applications folder, and double-click the install icon to install macOS Sequoia. Next, I click Continue, Agree, and Show All Disks. As before, I select my external APFS volume and click Continue. It will take a while. I'll pause recording this video and return once the installation is complete. The installation process took approximately 60 minutes and required 2 reboots. Following the installation, I spent around 15 minutes on the initial setup. It's essential to have your user account password, network password, and Apple ID password available during the setup. I can now test and explore the new features of macOS Sequoia. I will have more tutorials on macOS 15 Sequoia in the near future. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please consider subscribing by clicking on the LT Lucid Tutorials logo and sharing the video link with your friends. Your support will inspire me to create more videos for you. Thank you for watching.